I think something's wrong here. I'm making an RPG game called Mana Valley. In it, you play as an adventuring witch, and I'll be honest, this story still needs a lot of work. Mechanically, at least, I intend it to be a kind of mashup between some of my favorite games like Zelda, Stardew Valley, New World, and World of Warcraft. I started making it about a month ago, and boy, is it a reminder of how difficult making a game is. You don't think about how much time goes into every little thing in a game when you play it, and one small change can turn into a dozen very quickly. For example, here's the first enemy in the game I created. They're called Pomploos. Shout out to Tony Ferrelli for the name suggestion on Twitter. Bop Sprout, Onion, Scrump, and Bing Bong were also suggestions, so let me know if you like any of those better or if you have your own. The first thing I created on them was the ability to take damage. Saying that out loud makes me feel like some kind of monster, but I'm just trying to keep the development player focused. When damaging anything, the player needs a visual indication of how much damage they dealt. So I added some health bars over them. To reduce visual clutter on this screen, the health bars only show for a few seconds after the enemy's health changes. Specifically, health change and not just decrease, because I also added in the ability for Pomploos to regenerate their health, and it's important for players to see that too. But attacking an enemy that just stands still and takes it isn't very challenging, so I added in different enemy states. No, not that kind of state, this kind. So by default, Pomploos roam about. And when a player gets too close, they start chasing, and they stop chasing when the player is far enough away. But if a player attacks them, then they enter an aggro state, which is similar to a chase, but has a much farther range. However, I didn't want the Pomploos to chase the player over the entire map, so when they're too far from home, they retreat. But I realized that you could just stand outside their max range and attack them while they retreated. So I made it so that while they're retreating, they don't take any damage. That was all good, but defeating a single one of these enemies was never going to be very difficult on its own. So I created an alert radius so that when a player damages one, it alerts any other nearby enemies to chase the player as well. This ended up causing enemies to clump up, which on its own I was okay with, but because of the way I had created the spellcasting, only one enemy in this clump could ever be damaged at a time, and it didn't feel very satisfying. To fix this, I added a kind of splash damage. Now the damage gets dealt to any enemies within a radius that I can increase or decrease per spell, and now it feels much more natural. I was also using a simple character controller for the enemies, but that made them too dumb to know how to go around things. But here the Pomploo just continuously runs into the tree.
Why do people run from me?
For now, instead of making an entire AI system, I just made them navigate via a nav mesh, which is just this blue area that gets created beforehand and tells things where they can and can't go. Even with all that, defeating enemies is only fun if there's some kind of incentive to do so. So I made it so that when defeated, Pomploos drop XP and mana orbs and have a chance to drop other loot as well. The loot system is dynamic, so as I add more items into the game, I can literally just drag and drop them into a loot table as I go. At this point, the Pomploo prefab was all set, but they had to be manually placed into the scene, and after they were defeated, the level needed to be restarted for them to respawn. One of the things I really enjoy about some RPG games is the ability to grind out items and experience by staying in an area and repeatedly defeating enemies. I think being able to improve your character in this somewhat passive way is important. If a player gets to a point that is particularly difficult, they can always fall back on this method for improvement. I wanted to include this in Mana Valley, so I made an enemy spawner that spawns a maximum number of enemies and will respawn them over time. This might seem like a lot of polish for such an early stage in my game, but starting with a basic enemy, which has fleshed out all of the fundamental behaviors, gives me a good foundation to build other enemies from. In non-enemy news, I made chests that drop items. This is also based on their own loot table, and I included some visual effects and camera changes to make it feel a little more special. I also made it so that the looting process is interrupted if the player takes damage. This is to avoid players running into an area, looting a chest, and leaving without having to fight any enemies leading up to the chest. Since the player can take damage, I added some sounds for when they are hit, and when their health reaches zero, they perform a death animation and they drop all of their currently held loot. Pressing a button teleports them to a respawn shrine that glows red, fades to white, and then fades off. And maybe I should reset their death animation too. That's better. There's another shrine I made for fast traveling that gets activated after a few seconds when a player walks over it. I think in the future, I might make these activated from a spell instead of just being a button. There's a lot more I'm working on, but let me know what you'd like to see next. You can now wishlist the game on Steam, so check the description for the link. And unless you're full of darkness inside, make sure to like and subscribe.